Welcome back, Nick and Lex here. Thank you so much for joining me to another episode of Music with Nick. Today, we got some amazing music lined up, some jazz fusion, and I'm super happy because I'm going to go see another jazz fusion legend today with my wife, Alexia, and I'm super stoked. We're going to go see Richie Kotzen, and I'm sure a lot of you know who he is. If not, check him out. We do have some reaction videos through Richie Kotzen, a great friend of Greg Howe, a former player with Mr. Big. He also plays with the Winery Dogs, and I think he also was the guitar player of Poison. But don't be fooled. He's not, he used to be pretty much a shredder, like the 80s shredder, but he's very well like versed in blues and jazz fusion, and he's just amazingly good on the guitar, and of course also a great singer. Like, he just has a voice incredible. So I'm super stoked about seeing him today, but let me tell you about what we got lined up for today. So this is, we're gonna start out with Jan Hammer. This is a marathon requested by our great friend and supporter and subscriber RG, and he's also sponsoring the video, of course. So we're gonna start with Jan Hammer from his The First 7 Days album. This is 1975. Let's see, Oceans and Continents. Then we're gonna play some Jeff Beck with the amazing and incredible Terry Bozzio and Tony Hymas. This is the Jeff Beck Guitar Shop with Terry Bozzio, etc. This is, let's see, 1989. Wow, cool. I love the cover. It looks like a car. Where they repair your vehicle, but it's a guitar. Really cool. And the song is called Where Were You? And it says with Terry Bozzio and Tony Hymas. So cool. I loved, I know Terry Bozzio from his recordings with Black Light Syndrome. I know he played with Frank Zappa. So, yeah. So then we're going to play some more Mahavishnu Orchestra, Birds of Fire. This is the album. This is 1973. And the song Thousand Island Park. Then somebody who I'm very familiar with, Joe Satriani, the Extremist. Let's see. Cryin. I'm sure I've heard this before, but you know, I haven't heard Joe Satriani in maybe 15 years. So I didn't want to like change it. I think it's going to give the marathon a lot of strength. And I've never done any Joe Satriani. I think we did one, Surfing with the Alien, that song. But yeah, that's going to be fun. And then we're going to do another Jeff Beck, the final piece. And this is There and Back. He could have called it maybe There and Beck. This is 1980. Oh, and then Joe Satriani, the Extremist, 1992. So yeah, so that's like my stuff that I used to listen to a lot. Joe Satriani, Steve Vai, Ingrid Malmsteen, you know the drill. So, but yeah, but I also listened to a lot of like, you know, Greg Howe, Alan Holdsworth at that time. So yeah, this is going to be a lot of fun. So let's start it off with Mr. Jan Hammer. Here we go. So basically we're doing some Mahavishnu Orchestra, but separately. Because I did some Billy Cobham the other day. So RG's marathons have been a lot of, about these players, a lot of jazz fusion that I love. So it's a lot of fun to react to these. And so here we go. Oceans and Continents. Here we go. Have fun. Also, if you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. You know how it goes. But yeah, let's have some fun. Thank you. It's just amazing. Like, this guy is on a different level. Different level. Like, that harmony, I mean, the chord progressions, and then that solo. Oh, my Lord. That was amazing. It really sounds like out there, you know? Like, it says ocean continents. Man, this was good. I mean, I'm not even halfway through, and it's so good. Wow. Let's just continue. Let's, like, not stop. Just the whole chord structure and the whole theme and that improvisation was just insane. What a great musician. It's so crazy because I always thought that for some reason, like, I didn't know these musicians, right? So when I would listen to 70s music, I was like, well, they were like onto something here. And then, you know, in the 80s, they're perfected. Which is so stupid to think. Because, I mean, all the guitar plays that I listen to are from the 80s and 90s. And that's when they're like, you know, got all like jazz fusion-y. Supposedly, you know, what I knew. But this, I mean, I've never heard this before. And it's from the 70s. And I could play this to many friends and they would be blown away. That was still in the 70s. You know, it sounds like something out of like Dream Theater. Like, you know, like Jordan Rudess could play. And I can't believe that he came up with Miami Vice. That he must have come up with this in like 2 minutes, you know? I mean, it's so simple for him. Wow. Okay, let's just move along because I'm just going to start to like talk. So this is the next one is Where Were You with Terry Bozzio, Jeff Beck, and Tony Hymas. I of course know Terry Bozzio, Jeff Beck. I've gotten to know in the last couple of videos, but as a joint unit, the Jeff Beck Guitar Shop, I've never heard. So let's check it out. That reminds me a lot of Jason Becker. I mean, I can see where Jason Becker got a lot of influences from, like, Jeff Beck. Holy shit. Sorry for cursing, but this was just... poof. Wow, man. Like, I'm gonna send this to so many people, to so many guitar players that I know, that I know that don't know Jeff Beck, because I was always looking for stuff, like, you know, in Mexico with my friends, like the guitar players, and we're always looking for the next big thing, but we never went backwards. This is amazing what he just did there with only a guitar and some, like, synth. Very cool. All right. So let's move it along with Mahavishnu Orchestra, Thousand Island Park. And nice try there, RG. I almost lost it there, but no. Very cool notes, man. Okay, Thousand Island Park. Here we go. Almost sounds like the guitar trio, you know, with Aldi Meola and then, you know, Stanley Clark. I don't know who's on the bass, but I know it's Billy Cobham on the drums, John McLaughlin on the guitar, and Jan Hammer on the keys. Great. It sounds really like Aldi Meola's stuff, you know, from the 90s. Very cool. It's 1973. I don't even know when Aldi Meola's first record came out, but I think there was at the same time then. I don't know if, like, I think John McLaughlin is a little bit older than Aldi Meola. Could be wrong, but I can't. I'm not going to look it up now. Let's just enjoy. This is so good. Beautiful piece, like everything, you know, everything, acoustic bass, piano, guitar, and mastery. What do you need? What else do you need? Nothing. So good. I love that I could listen to some Mahavishnu Orchestra unplugged. That was very, very refreshing. Not that I don't like them plugged in. I mean, they're all virtuosos and they're all amazing. But this was very, very interesting. Very cool. Thank you. Earthquake. So now Joe Satriani is next. So like I said, I might know this. I have to listen to it. But let's do some Joe Satriani. Even if I recognize it, I would recognize it like immediately. Let's just check it out. So this is the Extremist, and this is 92. Let's go. Thank you. of course. I mean, as you can see, I'm playing air guitar. I actually learned this once, but I didn't remember that it was Cryin. Yeah, very cool. I literally learned this once. I didn't remember that it, the name of the song, you know. I was just learning so much stuff. So yeah, this is beautiful, very nice ballad, you know, with an electric guitar. Let's continue.
Thank you.
had like goosebumps there for a second, even though I've heard the song, I've learned the song, but it's still so good. And I hadn't heard it in years. Maybe 7-8 years. So yeah, it still holds up, of course, like all this great music. But I mean, just the phrasing, the intention there, the theme is so really beautiful, you know, the execution. It's not too heavy. It's just Joe Satriani is such a good player. And he has introduced me also to so many good players. Like, I didn't know Eric Johnson. Then I saw the G3 with Eric Johnson. I did know Steve Vai. I know they have like a relationship together since the 80s where they were like teaching themselves and stuff. I think Satriani was teaching Vai when he first started. And then like the G3 with John Petrucci. I know John Petrucci because of Dream Theater, but then he did also Yngwie Malmsteen, a G3. That was like my dream come through, like Steve Vai, Yngwie Malmsteen, and Joe Satriani on the same stage is like mind bending. I also met another guitar player, actually, that's on the list, not on this marathon, but another marathon I'm going to do for RG, Mike Keneally, in the first G3 they ever did. And I think they play a Jeff Beck. I don't know if it's Jeff Beck, but I'm going down, 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 down. I think that's Jeff Beck, but I could be wrong. And then, Guthrie, Guven, like Paul Gilbert, you know, every player who has been on the stage with those two, with Satriani and Vai, it's just amazing. But I mean, that's like basically what I was into. That's why I don't know all this 70s music, you know, because I was more into 90s and after the 90s and Liquid Tension, Spastic Ink, Ron Jarzombek, and Alan Holdsworth stuff. And I never got into Alan Holdsworth stuff too much from the 70s, which must be insanely good. But he did like come out with this real tone and style in the 80s and then in the 90s and until like 2008. I think that was his last album. Wow. But okay, so we're going to finish this off with Jeff Beck, the final piece. This is from There and Back. And this is, let's see, 1980. This is a great piece. I love that I could do this because a lot of people don't know maybe Joe Satriani and they're going to find something to go into. That's another rabbit hole you can go into. That player doesn't mess around. He's good and he's instrumental music. First class, you know, first, like, just like that Jeff Beck tune, the Where Were You, that's like, and like all these are instrumental. And I love doing these marathons, RG. Thank you so much. I love instrumental music. Like, you can just give me instrumental music all day. So yeah. Okay, so let's finish it off with Mr. Beck here and on the guitar. Let's go. Wow. So I get it now. I get it now. RG was basically trying to show me like these players, but their lighter side, or not their lighter side, but more like a heartfelt, you know, just like more. And you almost got me to cry once, so that's pretty good. But it's just like Satriani was playing. It was just more like emotional, you know, the whole thing. I mean, that piece by Jeff Beck, he is like on my top like 10 now, you know. I mean, literally, like, I don't know. I've always heard of Jeff Beck and the Yardbirds, and there is no comparison, man. Like, with, like, because I, like, Jimmy Page and him that were in the same band. Like, I'm sorry, but I have a new favorite, you know? Like, Jeff Beck is insane. He's so good. You know, I've never heard Jimmy Page play like this. Never. I mean, okay, now, please don't murder me, but I've only heard him in Led Zeppelin, and he does not play like this in Led Zeppelin. I mean, there is some amazing solo work, like solos, but never heard Jimmy Page by himself, so maybe I have to do that. But Jeff Beck is a monster, man. I mean, just listen. You just repeat the song. Insane. Wow. Well, I'm really blown away by all these amazing musicians, all these, it's just so good. But thank you. Thank you, RG, for this marathon. This was amazing. I'm just like blown away. Thank you so much. Well, I hope everybody enjoyed. Let me know who was your favorite. You know, what was your favorite piece? And yeah, you know, I'm just gonna like, you know, deep dive into these bands. Although I don't want to spoil it, you know, I'd rather take requests, but I have to. I can't react to everything in the world. So, but I'm gonna start listening to Jeff Beck. He is good. He's so good. And everything. I mean, Jan was amazing. Satriani, Mahavishnu Orchestra was amazing. I love it that both songs by Jeff Beck just blew my mind. So yeah, I know what I'm going to listen to today on my way to listening to Richie Kotzen. So thank you so much again. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for this marathon. Thank you everyone for watching. And I hope to see you in the next one. Take care.